Hey guys! Welcome to the second part of the series on the Vult modules. A few days ago, a new module was released, Nurage, a very interesting Low-Pass Gate, and Vult is actually another Low-Pass Gate module, Julste, so in this video we will look at both of them. Let's start! Okay, so Nurage is a part of the Vult Premium modules, and it's also a part of Freak and Incubus, minus the VCA and Vector functions, and Julste is in the Free Modules bundle, and let me try to explain first what a Low-Pass Gate is. Imagine hitting a drum, or try even hitting the table with your finger. If you hit with less force, the sound will be sort of muffled and dark, and when you start hitting with more force, the sound becomes somewhat brighter. This is the effect we get by using a low-pass gate. When the module receives a gate, the cutoff point of the low-pass filter will open, and the sound will become brighter, just like when hitting a drum. And that's why it's usually used in the process of creating percussive sounds, and it's actually a low-pass filter and the VCA in one module. Now, there are a few differences between Julste and Nurage, so let's look at their features and then look at some examples. And let's start with Julste. Julste, as it's mentioned here, is a simple low-pass gate. It has a range knob to control the range of the incoming gate, and we have also an offset knob to add an offset, positive or negative, so we can control the limits of the incoming signal. We have also a resonance knob to control the resonance, of course, and a sharpness knob that when turned all the way to the right, the gate will affect the sound very fast and the sound will become more snappy, and by turning to the left, the gate will act more and more like an envelope rather than a gate, so the sound will be less snappy and more subtle. And of course, we also have dedicated attenuverters for all four knobs. This module has two modes, VCA and low-pass, so we can choose to use it in VCA mode to control the amplitude of the signal, or in low-pass mode to control the filter's cutoff point. And we have the gate input, the signal input, and the signal output. Now let's see how Nurage looks like. Nurage is a dual low-pass gate or filter, and you will soon see why it's also a filter. This module accepts both mono and stereo signals, and it has also a resonance knob to control the resonance, but here we have a drive knob, like we used to see in filters, so we can drive the incoming signal and cause the filter to saturate and add interesting harmonics to the sound. And also here we have dedicated attenuverters for both resonance and drive functions. We have the main cutoff knob to control the cutoff frequency, and we have three control voltage inputs to control this knob, two gate inputs and one CV input, all with dedicated attenuverters. Because it's a stereo module, we have two gate inputs, one for each channel, and by using this switch here, we can decide if the gates would be connected / linked, or if they will operate separately, what can create a nice stereo effect. With the CV input, we can modulate the cutoff point by using an envelope generator, for example, or an LFO, and so on. We can also turn on VCA mode by using this switch here, and when in VCA mode, the cutoff knob controls the level and slightly also the cutoff point. Here we have the Vectral switch, so we can turn the Vectral on and off. A Vectral in the real world is a component which reacts to light, and because its reaction is non-linear, it's often used as a natural envelope generator. And also here, when activated, the percussiveness of the sound will be softened and less sharp. Now let's look at some examples and how Julste and Nurage sound like. Okay, so here we have one Julste and one Nurage, and we have the first voice. This is the first voice. It's coming from the Even VCO, The even VCO is receiving pitch information from the it's also a sort of a grid sequencer from DBs this time, and it's then sending a sawtooth wave to Julste, and from there it's going to the mixer, and Julste is receiving a gate from the gate sequencer. It's on low pass mode, and you can see when I turn the sharpness knob to the left or to the right, it becomes more snappy or less snappy. And this is really cool to play with live. So this is the first voice. Let's listen to the second voice that's coming from Noxious. And this time it's going through Nurage. Noxious is receiving pitch information also from this grid sequencer. And Nurage is receiving two different gates, also from the gate sequencer, and the gate inputs are unlinked. So we have a nice stereo effect. And also here we can play with the parameters a bit more resonance. Open the cutoff a bit more. And you can listen and see how different they sound like. This is again Julste. And this is Nurage. And let's add some drums. I'm triggering the drums or the mixer modules with the MIDI trigger module using my computer keyboard. Let's add some hi-hat. Very nice. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so here I've created a few percussive sounds using only the functional VCO as a sound source, which is actually the fundamental VCO, but this is the Squinky Labs version. And I have a couple of Julste modules and Nurage. The topograph from Valley is driving everything here. And let's listen to the first voice. You can hear it's a sort of a drum. It's the functional VCO is sending a triangle wave to Julste. Julste is receiving a trigger again from the topograph. And again, we can play with the sharpness. And to change the sound a bit, again, it's on low pass mode. So this is the first one. Let's listen to the second one. This time, the dysfunctional VCO is sending a sine wave to Julste again. The sharpness of Julste is being modulated by a sample and hold unit here from utilities or kinks from Audible Instruments. So it has variation in sound. We can also change the pitch of this functional VCO and get different results. And you can hear how snappy it is, how percussive this is. Very nice. Let's add the third voice. This is coming from this functional VCO. It's sending a sine wave and a triangle wave to Nurage. From there, it's going to the mixer, and we have Nurage. It's being modulated by two gates coming from topograph, and it's again unlinked, so we have this stereo effect. And also the cutoff point is also being modulated by the same sample and hold. can also play with it a bit to add more craziness to the sound. And this is also really percussive. And here we have another voice, more bassy, coming from another functional VCO, sending a triangle wave and a square wave this time to Nurage. The pulse width of the square wave is being modulated by the same sample and hold. And this time Nurage is receiving only one gate, also from Topograph. And also here we can play with the cutoff point of the filter. And you can hear how percussive those sounds are. And it's all thanks to the Low-Pass Gates, if it's Nurage or Julste. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so here we have just one Julste module, because I wanted to show you the Nurage versions in the Compacts modules bundle. If you have Incubus and Freak, you get Nurage as a filter without the VCA and the vectoral functions, but it's still a really nice sounding filter. So here we have Incubus and we have Vesek. And let's start with the first voice, which is coming from Vesek. It's going through Freak. And it's actually outputting a stereo signal. So let's listen to both of them. It's receiving pitch information from this phrase sequencer, and it's also sending two different gates to Freak. Let's open the cutoff point, listen to how this filter sounds like. Very, very nice. So this is the Freak version, and here we have Incubus. Let's listen to this here. It's again set on Nurage filter, and it's receiving pitch information and a gate from another phrase sequencer. Very nice. It's a very nice sounding filter. And here we have the Turing machine. It's outputting noise to Julste. From there it's going to the mixer, and it's receiving a gate also from the Turing machine, from its first trigger output. It's Julste, the offset of Julste is also being modulated by the Turing machine, so we get differences in sound. And this is a sort of a hi-hat sort of sound. The Turing machine is also modulating the panning of this channel. Let's listen to this. Very nice. And that's it, guys. Those were Julste and Nurage. Both are Low-Pass Gates, but they are quite different from one another and can be used in different ways. Like always, there will be a link to all the different patches we looked at today in the description, and also a link to Vult's website and to Leonardo's YouTube channel. Leonardo is the developer of the Vult modules. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell, and have a good one.